Next, let's look at the various ways that Vim can do autocomplete. So the first is to autocomplete using a symbol or string in the current buffer. So one line below, you see user session. So I'm going to start typing that. And now I press tab to select it. You can see in the overlay, there's a right-hand column with square brackets buffer inside it. That means the source for this autocomplete suggestion is the current buffer. And there you go, I'm gonna get rid of it. The next type of autocomplete, a very common one, is to autocomplete based on functions that are anywhere in the codebase. I'm doing this via Universal Ctags, and basically, remember we had a function called mark X. I think mark is seen. Yeah, there you go. So I can tab through it and you can see these are sourced from tags. So here we go. I've got this one here. It's going to turn red because I haven't imported this, but we don't need this here. So I'm just going to delete it. The third type of autocomplete worth looking at is file name autocompletion. So what I can do here is just start specifying a file name and Vim will autocomplete that. You can see here, we've got discounts.js suggested as a file. That's very handy for imports and that kind of thing. Now, let's move on to the fourth and probably the most exotic type of autocomplete, line-based autocompletion. Now, imagine for whatever reason, I'm creating a function that's sort of similar to the one below, and I want that line return config for, and then I'll change the argument. So I'll just start typing return, and then C, and now I press Control X, Control L for line-based autocomplete. And now I can just grab that one there and bingo, I've got it. I can go and change this as I please. But I don't really want this, so I'm just going to delete all that. Now, the very last type of autocompletion here is dictionary word autocompletion. So let's say I want to print out the message, Vim is awesome, but I don't want to type the rest of all. So I'm lazy like that. So here I press Control X, Control K, and it'll populate it with words from the dictionary, just like that. Oh wait, I nearly forgot the most important of all the autocomplete functionalities in a modern Vim setup, the language server protocol autocomplete. So to demonstrate that, I'm going to open up my product class from the Ruby on Rails side of my codebase. And then in a vertical split, I'm going to open up a completely blank new Ruby file. Now in the left pane, I'm going to instantiate a product in Ruby, which is product.new. Next, I'm going to call dot on this product instance. And as you can see, all these methods that are available in the product class in the right-hand pane are now available. And sometimes there are even arguments like the defaults given within this overlay.
See you next time.